weird animals be? Yes. On day one, we got to see some lepers and saw them be healed. And we learned that even when you're left out,
Jesus loves you!
On day two, we got to meet a young Samaritan woman. Can someone tell me her name?
Rachel.
Good job. Rachel taught us that even though you're different,
Jesus loves you!
On day three, we got to see Jesus being a servant to his disciples by washing their feet. Peter taught us that even when you don't understand,
Jesus loves you!
And then yesterday, we got to see Jesus pay the ultimate price for our sins. He did that by dying on the cross. And he taught us that even though you do wrong,
Jesus loves you!
Well, today we're learning that even when you're afraid,
Jesus loves you!
Okay, well, today's story is about a young man named Ananias, all right? And the reason why he was afraid is because God asked him to do something quite unthinkable. God asked him to heal Saul and restore his vision. Now, to understand why Ananias was so afraid of healing Saul, you have to understand who Saul is and what he did. Saul was a persecutor of Christians. He would go around and he would hunt down Christians and he would kill them. He would stone them, mock them, beat them, put them in jail. So it's pretty understandable why Ananias was so scared to heal Saul. But God had his own plan. God was looking out for Ananias because he loved him. Even though Ananias was afraid, God still loved him. So let's go ahead and take a look at the rest of our story and see exactly what happens with Ananias and Saul.
I made tea.
No thanks. I don't want any tea.
That's good. This is my tea. I didn't make it for you. No touching.
Oh, well then why didn't you tell me?
It's a great conversation starter.
That's a horrible conversation starter.
Oh, is it? We're conversing right now. Checkmate. And that's how it's done.
Haha, very funny. Are those the wines I've been asking for?
Oh, yes, they are. You did a mighty fine job writing them, if I do say so myself.
Flattery will get you nowhere. And I did do a great job writing these, and I do say so myself.
I've come for my warrants.
You know, once upon a time, you used to stop by and say hello, and how do you do?
Sorry. Hello?
How do you do?
How do you do?
Very fine, thank you for asking. Here's your warrants. You've done a mighty fine job first getting all those Christians.
Thank you. Looks like I'm going to Damascus next. And from the looks of things, there will be plenty of Christians to hunt down. There will never be a dull moment.
Well, I wish you safe travels. Live long and prosper.
Just keep waking it all, roll again. My love is taking me, said to my head. I keep waking it all, roll again.
Are you sure that we're headed toward Damascus?
I'm positive. Why do you say that?
Well, it just doesn't look very Damascus-y.
Don't worry. I know this place like the back of my hand. Ah, that's new. Well, maybe you got a point.
Well,
maybe you're right.
Should we ask someone for directions?
What? We never ask for directions. We secretly look for directions using a map. Get it out.
Right.
You blockhead. We're going the wrong way. Damascus is the other way. Why didn't you tell me?
I did for the past hour.
Oh. Well, we gotta turn around. Come on, maybe we can get it right this time. To infinity and beyond.
Just keep waking on the road again. My, my love is making music with my hand. I keep waking on the road again.
Come on, Saul, hurry up. We finally made it.
Excellent. So, what's our first destination in that lovely city?
It's getting brighter. It's so pretty. Here comes the sun. Doo 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 doo.
What? No. Don't think that's the sun.
Are you okay?
Hell, the fallen, I can't get up. out the lights.
No one did. Saul, how many fingers am I holding up?
Yes.
What exactly are you seeing right now?
I don't know. Everything's black.
Saul, I think you're blind.
Saul, why are you persecuting me?
What is that? Who are you?
I am Jesus, the one you're hunting down. I want you to get up and enter the city. In the city, you'll be told what to do next.
Let's not. Jacob, let's just go home.
No. I think we better do as he says.
How? How do I go into the city? I can't even see the next stone I'm stepping on.
Of course you can't. This is a dirt road. Don't worry, I'll help you out.
Saul remained blind for 3 days. He wouldn't eat anything and he wouldn't drink anything. He was very upset about the fact that he lost his vision and he didn't know if he was going to get it back. But God loved Saul anyways. He sent Ananias to go heal Saul and restore his vision. Let's take a look at the rest of our story and see what happens with Saul.
I'm telling you, Anna, it was the weirdest dream ever.
Weird, yes. Truthful, no. There is no way that God would ask you to do something like that. What's he trying to do? Get you killed?
Are you calling me a liar?
I ain't calling you a truther.
It really happened.
Okay, then. Run your dream by me again. Let's see if I can get this right.
All right, so it went a little bit like this.
Ananias.
Oh, yes, Master?
Get up and go over to Straight Avenue. Ask at the house of Judas for a man from Tarsus. His name is Saul. He's there praying. He has just had a dream in which he saw you enter the house and lay hands on him so he could see again and be healed.
Master, you can't be serious. I mean, I've heard all about this man named Saul. The terrible things he's been doing, and his reign tear upon your people of Jerusalem. And now he has papers from the chief priests that allow him to do the same here.
Don't argue. Go. I have picked him as my personal representative to non-Jews and kings and Jews. And now I'm about to show him what he's in for. The hard suffering that goes with this job.
Wow, you remember all that? I can't even remember what I had for breakfast this morning.
No, it was toast. But, do you understand now?
No, I still don't understand why Jesus would ask you to do that. But I do believe you, so what are you going to do?
Be obedient, of course. I'm going to go to the house of Judas, and I'll find Saul.
Aren't you scared?
Oh, I'm terrified. What if they arrest me, throw me in the pokey? Or worse. What if they kill me? You remember the stone of Stephen?
Boy, do I. Not a pretty sight.
And I'm not going to have that happen to me. But I know that if God wants me to do this, then he will protect me. And everything will be okay, because even when I'm afraid, Jesus loves me. And I know he'll be there when I approach Saul.
Well, good luck. I'll be praying for you.
Thanks, sis. I'm off.
Have you seen a man named Saul?
No?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, yes.
He's right there.
Oh, you see,
yes,
you
he's right there.
Wait, are you sure? Yes. Yes. Actually,
he's
right
there.
He's over there.
Yes.
He's right there.
But I have to be obedient to what God wants me to do. Wait, where'd he go?
Yeah, I know how I look. What do you want?
Well, God came to me in a vision. He told me
that
you...
Yeah, I'm signing autographs, right? Because I am. I've become more popular since I started persecuting those Christians. I don't want to be proud of that anymore.
Well, not exactly. He told me to come find you so that
to
I
To give
could...
me lunch, right? Because I'm pretty hungry. But, you see...
Okay, Brother Saul, now just... God came to me, the same Jesus who blinded you. He told me to come heal you so you may be filled with the Holy Spirit.
That's a pretty big jump. What are you looking at? I can see you. I can see. Jacob, I can see. I can see. Hurry, we have to go into town to tell everyone what's happened. This is the best day ever. I can see.
What an awesome story so far. Saul was a persecutor of Christians, so it's pretty understandable why Ananias was really afraid to heal him. Maybe Ananias felt like a weird animal, you know, the wrong guy for the job. Or maybe he thought the request was a weird one. After all, Saul was trying to kill Christians. But Ananias needed to remember that God was bigger than Saul, that his plans stretched beyond our limited view. With an extra nudge from God, Ananias was obedient and healed Saul. After Saul was healed, he went into the town and told everyone what had happened. And then they all threw a huge party and celebrated. Let's watch the rest of our story and see the others party.
Everyone, everyone, gather around, gather around. Come see what has happened. I was once lost, but now I'm found. I was once blind, but now I see. It's all because of Jesus. He saved me.
Wait, aren't you Saul, the persecutor of Christians?
Yeah, he is. What's going on? He kills Christians.
It's a trap!
It's not a trap. What you say is true, but not anymore. All that's changed now.
Wait, what are you talking about? We don't understand.
Okay. Well, I was on the road coming here to hunt for Christians. I hated Christians. Suddenly, a light came down from heaven. I fell to the ground. Heard a voice say, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" I didn't know who was speaking. Then the voice said, "I am Jesus, the one you are persecuting. He said to get up and go into the city, then you'll be told what to do." It wasn't Jesus. When I got up, I was completely blind. I couldn't see a thing. So my friend had to lead me into the city to a house. I've been there for 3 days. But the Lord sent a man to help me. A man named Ananias.
What, Ananias? That guy's my friend.
Yeah, mine too. What have you done with him?
Nothing. He's perfectly fine. God sent him to help me. When he laid his hands on me, I could see again. I don't know how Jesus could love someone like me with all the things I've done. But he does.
Wow, that's a miracle. Amen.
Praise the Lord!
What are we standing around here for? Let's party! First, let's thank God for all he's done. Thank you, Lord, for your great, great love. It's so amazing. Thank you, Lord, for always sticking with us and for always, always loving us. Whenever we're afraid of someone or something, help us to remember the story of Saul and Ananias. Let us never forget that even when we're afraid, Jesus loves us. In your name, amen. Now let's party.
Let's party.
Stand up. Stand up.
You are all we need. Your love has saved. tonight.